NFRA has issued a consultation paper on 29 September 2021 on statutory audit and auditing standards for micro, small and medium companies for comments by its stakeholders. NFRA has done an analysis of MCA data, and focus of the analysis is companies with net worth below Rs. 250 crores. These companies are referred to as micro, small and medium companies for the purpose of this consultation paper. They have discussed lot of data of filings by small companies and audit fees levels and indebtedness status of companies. Indebtedness status indicates the public money involved in the companies. They have given comparisons with other countries too. And at the last, they have come to a conclusion that audit for small companies is not required. In light of this, today we will discuss why NFRA was formed in the first place. What are the powers and duties of NFRA? What conclusions they have reached and questions they have raised in the consultation paper, and why it all doesn't make any sense. Dear professional friends, before moving ahead, please subscribe to our channel as we keep discussing such crucial topics which can make real difference to your practice and its growth. And if subscribed, you can get regular notifications whenever we release next videos. NFRA, National Financial Reporting Authority, was constituted under Section 132 of the Companies Act 2013, and its powers are as under: A. Make recommendations to the central government on the formulation and laying down of accounting and auditing policies and standards for adoption by companies or class of companies or their auditors, as the case may be. B. Monitor and enforce the compliance with accounting standards and auditing standards in such manner as may be prescribed. And C. Oversee the quality of service of the professions associated with ensuring compliance with such standards and suggest measures required for improvement in quality of service. In respect to notifying accounting standards and auditing standards, following is the procedure. First, ICAI will recommend, and second, NFRA will check and recommend to CG for notifying it. To sum up, NFRA's duty is to recommend accounting and auditing policies and standards in the country, undertake investigations and impose sanctions against defaulting auditors and audit firms in the form of monetary penalties and debarment from practice. The Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, ICAI, had initially opposed the idea of a regulator for the sector, saying the existing structure was working well. But the government clarified that the role of the new regulator and those of ICAI will not overlap. But looking at the consultation paper, it seems ICAI was right. NFRA is certainly crossing their powers. Now let's come to the consultation paper and the questions being asked by NFRA for comments by stakeholders. Question 1. Do you think that micro, small and medium companies, depending upon some criteria and threshold, should be exempted from the mandatory statutory audit under Companies Act 2013? If not, why not? And if yes, what would be the criteria and thresholds for exemption? Here our answer is no. They should not be exempted. Because already by the Finance Act 2021, income tax audit is discarded for businesses with turnover up to 10 crores, provided that not more than 5% of the total transactions are in cash. GST audit has also been completely done away with. Now if statutory audit is also exempted, then what will be the control on private limited companies by government? It will lead to lot of wrong deeds taking place and no one will ever catch it. It won't be good for the economy. Further, as per Companies Accounting Standards Rules 2021, small and medium sized company, they are already eligible for certain exemptions from accounting standards. Further, we think banks won't be able to lend to small companies as there will be no basis for determining the eligibility or credibility of companies if audited balance sheets are not available. There will be leakages in tax collections also, and government will lose taxes if there is no proper control over books of accounts. We don't think audit fees is a real burden on small companies. Today, small companies are more concerned about late fees and penalties by MCA and other statutory laws like GST. So if anything is to be done to reduce tax burden and compliance burden, focus should be on MCA and GST compliances and bad infrastructure and not on audit. Now let's come to question 2. Do you think there is a requirement for a separate set of auditing standards for MSMCs as it exists for accounting standards? If no, why not? And if yes, what should be the basis for the same? Again, our answer is no. This is where powers and duties of NFRA and ICI tend to overlap. NFRA has no business to get into this. In accounting standards, there is minimal exemptions for MSCs, so question does not arise. Question 3, the cost of conducting an audit as per prescribed standards is an important input for the responses to questions 1 and 2. Do you agree with the approach for estimating standard cost of audit computed by NFRA? If not, which areas or assumptions need changes? Again, our answer is no. The estimated cost of audit is taken as high as Rs 4.57 lakhs even for a company with nil turnover, and that is too high. Last question was, do you think the current exemption thresholds for CARO, ICFR and statutory audit applicability need to be standardized and made uniform? If not, why not? And if yes, what would be the criteria and thresholds? Our answer is no here too. Reason is same as given in answer to question 1. Overall, this consultation paper seems very confusing. According to us, there is a need to revisit this consultation paper by NFRA and should be taken back. We request all of you to understand these pointers and write an email to NFRA and object strongly to the consultation paper. Let us know what you all think about this in comments box. Like and share this video with your colleagues so that all of us can discuss it further. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thank you for listening and keep growing.